Why do we see leaves as green and fire trucks as red? When we look at most objects, they appear colored because radiation from the sun bounces off them in light waves called photons. Photons scatter off objects and are received by our eyes. But when you watch TV, where do the colors come from? Today, colors on most TV screens come from a series of tiny lamps called light-emitting diodes, or LEDs. These LEDs emit three basic colors: red, green, and blue. In order to make other colors, the LEDs combine these three colors in various proportions. Since LEDs emit three colors with broad color profiles, they can struggle to represent colors with high precision. Quantum dots, on the other hand, are a new technology capable of emitting colors much more accurately. Scientists hope to fine-tune the distribution of colors so that the blue becomes bluer, the green becomes greener, and the red becomes redder. Quantum dots are microscopic. The size of a quantum dot relative to a human is like the size of a human relative to the sun. They are made from materials called semiconductors, which have special properties. Semiconductors have energy bands that electrons can move between. When a photon hits an electron, the electron absorbs the photon's energy and jumps to a higher energy band. To relax to a lower energy band, the electron can release a photon that matches the energy difference. This means the difference between the two energy levels determines the energy of the photon released, which is related to the color of the light. Scientists can alter the size of the quantum dot to fine-tune the energy difference between the two bands and change the color of the light emitted by the dot. Smaller dots actually have a larger energy difference between energy bands. To get all the way back down to the lower energy band, electrons must emit a photon with high energy, creating colors with short wavelengths like blue or violet. Larger dots have smaller energy differences between bands. These large dots give off lower energy light with longer wavelengths, creating hues of yellow or red. Scientists have been working hard to create quantum dots with high efficiency. For every photon these quantum dots absorb, several photons of the quantum dot's specific color come back out. Many newer TVs today use quantum dots because they produce more pure color in a more energy-efficient way than LEDs use in conventional TVs. However, quantum dots can be used in much more than just TV screens. With more precise colors, astronomers could collect more accurate data about the spectra of light coming from distant stars, giving more exact readings of the object's age and composition. In addition, quantum dots can be used to harvest sunlight and convert it into electricity. Scientists are also using quantum dots to develop better methods of medical imaging. Quantum dots can improve on the current technology of using dyes or other imaging agents to visualize cancer tumors by providing a better delineation between cancerous tissues and other tissues. Surgeons could operate with greater precision, helping preserve a patient's healthy tissue. However, more research needs to be done to determine if quantum dots are safe to use in humans. One advantage of using quantum dots is their small size, which allows them to be dispersed in liquids. Therefore, many liquid processing techniques, such as inkjet printing and spin coating, can be applied when using quantum dots. This allows quantum dots to be integrated into products quickly, easily, and at a low cost. Quantum dots are a new microscopic technology for emitting colored light. These tiny lights excite scientists because they are designed to emit highly specific colors in a very efficient way, paving the way for more vivid, lifelike displays. In the near future, there's a good chance your cell phone screen could be made from quantum dots. Soon, quantum dot technology will color our lives.